Around the year 937, in a kingdom that had only recently become England, a young noblewoman was born. She was named Wulfthryth, but was also known as Wulfrida. Not much is known of Wulfthryth's early life. She was staying at Wilton Abbey, but was probably not a nun, when she was abducted by the young King of England, Edgar the Peaceful, around the year 962. Bride abduction was not rare, and Wulfthryth was probably okay with it. Edgar had previously had a relationship with a woman named Ethelfled, and had possibly married her. Ethelfled was the mother of Edgar's oldest son, Edward the Martyr. Wulfthryth and Edgar had their own child, a daughter named Edith, around 963. We do not know if Edgar ever married Wulfthryth. After some time, Edgar and Wulfthryth grew bored of each other, and Edgar returned her to Wilton Abbey around 964. Wulfthryth became abbess of Wilton Abbey, and her daughter, Edith, was educated by the other nuns. Edgar seems to have remained kind to Wulfthryth and Edith, even as he remarried and had two more sons. Wulfthryth died around the year 1000 at Wilton Abbey. After returning Wulfthryth to Wilton Abbey, Edgar had married a woman named Elfthryth, with whom he had two sons, and one Ethelred the Unready survived to adulthood. After Edgar's death, his eldest son Edward the Martyr became king, something that Elfthryth was not okay with. Elfthryth the evil stepmother poisoned the king, who then became known as Edward the Martyr. Elfthryth's son with Edgar, Ethelred the Unready, succeeded his older half-brother, and the Anglo-Saxons would rule England until 1066, with quite a few exceptions. Wulfthryth was made a saint not so long after her death. Her feast day is on September 13th. Her daughter Edith predeceased her mother, and was also made a saint. Edith's feast day is a few days after her mother's.